Do you know that sometimes same program will return two different outputs in different compilers? So just like we have this program, so this program is not having any input parameters. We do not have anything in the body. There's no input parameters. If you give this program to different compilers, some compilers will say that this program fails because there's some kind of error. Some compilers will say that this program is legitimate. Okay, for example, if you give the same program to a GCC compiler, right? So our program fails in GCC as the return type of main is void, because in GCC, GCC accepts the return type as an integer. If you give this program in GCC, so GCC will say that return type should be integer because the return type is void. So this program will fail in GCC compiler. But if you execute the same program in Turbo C compiler, agar aap same program ko Turbo C ke andar execute karenge, so in this Turbo C compiler, this program will compile successfully. It is valid. It is valid in Turbo C. In Turbo C. But if you give the same program in GCC, it is not valid in case of GCC compiler. So it is very interesting that the same program which you feel is valid in one compiler, it is not valid in other compiler. So that's, you know, that's quite fascinating. Or you can say, you might feel that there's some kind of errors in the program, right? So you might feel that even if you have created a right program, you might feel that there's some kind of errors. So look at this program here. So there are many students who know this. I've taken this program as an example in my videos also. So look at this program here. So in this program, what is happening is we have a header file. This is fine. We are doing integer main. So integer means mean integer main and return type is zero means we are trying to execute this program in GCC compiler, because GCC compiler wants that the return type should be integer. Now what we are doing is we are taking a variable I, and here the variable I, the value is 1, and we are printing I++, I++, and I. Now can you tell me what is the output of this program? I want all of you to write the output of this program in the chat window. Just think about it. What should be the output of this program? So let me analyze the program on your behalf. If you're not giving me output, then I should do it on your behalf, even if I'm doing wrong. So I'm doing it on your behalf only. Okay, I'm not saying that. Okay, so this is the variable I, which is having a value 1. Now some of you say, sir, this program here, these statements will be executed from left to right. Okay, fine. So that means the first statement here, it will produce an output as 1, and it will make the value of I as 2. Then the second statement here, it will produce the output as 2, and it will make the value of I as 3. And the third statement here, it will produce the output as 3. So some of you say, sir, the output that will be produced here will be 1, 2, and 3. Okay, so there's some other category of students, they will also say, sir, these statements will be executed from right to left. So this is general misconception which people say. So I'm just taking your point of view. Maybe I'm saying it wrong, but I'm just thinking that this is what you are thinking here. So this is the variable I, and this initial value is 1. So some people will say, sir, it will execute from right to left. So that means first of all we are going to execute this, so it will produce the state output as 1. Then we are going to execute this, so it is going to produce the output as 1, but the value of I will become 2. Then we are going to execute this, so it will produce output as 2, the value of I will become 3. So we got two outputs here, so 1, 2, 3, and second output is 2, 1, 1. Now there are 14 students are watching this session. I want all of you to answer me, which of these output is correct? Isme se kaun sa correct hai? So Pranita is saying 1, 2, 3. Madhu is also saying 1, 2, 3. Okay, so let us try and figure out what exactly is the output. So if you execute this program in different compilers, so this is what are the possible outputs. So if you execute this program in GCC on Linux machine, so output is 2, 1, 3. So on Linux it is producing 2, 1, 3. On Sun Studio it is producing 1, 2, 3. So that is also on Linux. So if on Linux you are executing a GCC compiler, it will produce 2, 1, 3 output. On Linux, if you are executing Sun Studio compiler, it will execute 1, 2, 3. First one is 2, 1, 3. On Sun OS, So on this, if you are executing this same program using G++, so again it is 213. If you are executing same program on Sun Studio, again it is 123. So as you can see, it is producing different outputs on different machines as well as on different compilers. So basically we thought the output should be 123. Some of you may have given the output as 111, so obviously 111 is wrong. You are never going to get the output as 111 in any machines. Kisi bhi machine mein aapko iska output 111 nahi milega in any configuration. So output should be either 213 or it is 123. So it is 213 or it is 123, and sometimes you can also get the output as 112. So 112 is also a valid output. So this is basically an exact experiment. This is just based on the experiment. So you can see these values. I have not calculated this value. We have executed this program on different machines, and we found out by executing this program on different machines, these are the outputs that we are getting. But again, there are various possibilities of the output. You can have output as 123, you can have output as 213, you can have output as 211. So the same program is producing different results on different machines and different compilers. Agar aap different machines mein execute karenge or different compilers mein execute karenge same programs ko, then again it is producing problems. For example, here you can see, here if I say G++ 4.2.1 and again here also 4.2.1, so exactly the same compiler. They are both exactly the same compiler, but here the operating system is changed. We have a different operating system. Just because we changed the operating system, the output is different. Okay, now again you can see that this program on different machines producing different outputs, which is a problem because we cannot figure out that what is the correct answer. What might be the reason behind this? Can anyone tell me kiska reason kya ho sakta hai? Why, how can you get a different outputs on different machines? So basically you might be asking, sir, which compiler is correct? Isme se kaun sa compiler correct hai? So basically you can see there are various C standards. So in 1972 the C language was that was the birth of C language. In 1978 the first C standard was K and R C. In 1990, so we introduced one more standard, which is UNCC or ISOC. In 1999 there was a C99 standard. In 2011 there was C11 standard. In 2018 they also have C18 standard. So various standards are present. And what are these standards? So basically these standards are that there's a committee. So that committee decides that what are the basic functionalities, what are the features of the C should be there, as well as they decide the internal functioning of the compiler. I think I can say it like this. What is the C standard? The C standard hai kya? So what I want all of you to do is, after the class, read about what is the C standard. Just try to understand what exactly the meaning of C standard and what are the responsibilities of this committee. वो होता क्या है और इसकी responsibilities क्या है? And secondly, why am I even teaching you? मतलब आपको इसकी ज़रूरत क्यों है? Why am I even teaching you? Because most of the time in your examination, in UGC NET, in GATE, in ISRO, in all these three examinations, at least once in like 3 to 4 years, they ask one question which is based on this criteria, which is based on what we are going to study here. So they give a lot of problems based on this. So from my past experience, I know that this is a topic which is very important or aapko ye karna chahiye. That is why we are covering this topic. Okay. So we have C11, the draft of C11 is available. This is a link of the draft. I've already given you this presentation, so you can click this draft, and this is like 800 pages of the draft. It is like 800 pages. If you want to do more research on C language, then maybe you might want to read this entire draft. So maybe in your PhD, if you are working on compilers, or maybe you are doing some research on programming languages, so you might want to read this draft. So that is, I recommend, but not for the examination, because it's an 800 page draft and you don't want to spend your 6 months in just that one 800 page draft. So basically why it is giving different outputs, because C standard leaves some behavior of many C constructs as undefined, as unspecified. There are two types of behavior here. We have two types of behavior. One behavior is undefined behavior, and second behavior is unspecified behavior. So basically these are two different things. So whenever somebody says it is an undefined behavior, that is different. And whenever somebody said it is an unspecified behavior, that is different. Undefined is different and unspecified is different. Okay. In C language, the use of any automatic variable before it has been initialized yields an undefined behavior. Like, for example, if you are doing something like this, this is the main function, and you are doing integer a, and then you are doing printf percentage d comma a plus plus. So basically the output that you are going to get here, this output is a garbage value, right? So if this integer variable, and it is an auto variable, so automatic variable is an auto variable, so generally we do not use the term auto here. So any automatic variable, if for example this automatic variable is defined inside the main function, so the initial value of this variable is not defined. But if you have a variable like this integer b, now if this integer b is a global variable, so the initial value of a global variable is 0, but this initial value of this automatic variable is not defined. So when you try to print this value, then you are going to get some kind of garbage value. So yeah, why you are getting this garbage value? Because this behavior is undefined. इस बिहेवियर को हमने डिफाइन नहीं किया. दैट हाउ वट हैपन्स इफ यू हैव अ ऑटो वेरिएबल एंड यू हैव नॉट गिवन सम वैल्यू दैट ऑटो वेरिएबल. ओके, बट वट एग्जैक्टली दिस अनस्पेसिफाइड बिहेवियर? सो अनस्पेसिफाइड बिहेवियर इज ऑर्डर ऑफ, यस, अनस्पेसिफाइड बिहेवियर इज ऑर्डर ऑफ इवेल्युएशन ऑफ सब एक्सप्रेशंस. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इफ आई से दैट वी हैव अ कंप्लीट एक्सप्रेशन एंड हियर वी हैव मल्टीपल एक्सप्रेशन. इफ आई से वी हैव एफ फंक्शन, जी फंक्शन एंड एच फंक्शन एंड दिस इज सम फंक्शन फीब. सो वी हैव दीज थ्री फंक्शंस. नाउ दीज थ्री फंक्शंस हियर, द ऑर्डर ऑफ इवेल्युएशन ऑफ दिस सब एक्सप्रेशंस विच आर सेपरेटेड बाई कॉमास, दैट इज नॉट डिफाइंड, दैट इज नॉट स्पेसिफाइड. सो इफ यू लुक एट द सेम प्रोग्राम हियर, इफ यू लुक एट द सेम प्रोग्राम, why we are getting these different outputs here, why we are getting the output as 2 1 3, why we are getting the output as 1 2 3, if you are executing them this way, so the output you are going to get is 1 2 3. But if you are executing this statement first, sabse pehle agar aap middle statement ko execute karenge, if you are executing this statement first, then this is the input one, so then the output will be 1. Or you can say, let me do this way, if you are executing this statement first, then or this statement first, then output will be 1, this value will become 2, then you are executing this statement, then output will be 2, this value will be 3, and if you are executing this statement, the output will be 3. So basically the order of evaluation here is not defined. So this is an unspecified behavior. This is an unspecified behavior, right? Because here these are sub expressions, the order of evaluation of these sub expression is not defined. In one compiler it may read, give the output as 2 1 3, in another compiler it give the output as 1 2 3. This is an unspecified behavior. Okay, so just read again. So it is saying the order of evaluation of a sub expression is unspecified. Okay, so it is basically, it leaves the compiler to do whatever is easiest or most efficient. Why they have done it? They have not defined a lot of things, they have not specified a lot of things. There are two reasons. First of all, they wanted to keep the language as small as possible, as short as possible. They do not want to make the language very, very bulky. And secondly, they wanted to make the languages very fast. So if you have less number of statements to execute, less number of conditions the compiler has to check, that means the programming language will become very, very fast. And secondly, it leaves the compiler, it frees the compiler to do whatever the compiler wants. So then it becomes very easy, you know, whatever easiest. So it leaves the things, some things on the compiler, so the compiler can select whatever is easy for you. Okay, so we'll see all these things one by one. So this is some theory that I believe you can study. I'm not explaining this entire theory here. I can explain you some examples, but you know, I want all of you to just at least go through these after the class. Just go through the PPT, what is this undefined behavior and these things. Just go through this after the class and let me explain the program then. Okay, so go to this theory. I'm leaving this on you. You can read it after the class, you can pause the video maybe while if you are watching the video again, and then you can study this thing.